up, y'all? I want to do this video because there's some misconceptions out here and some things that's being misconstrued, and it's really ridiculous. And really, at the heart of the matter, I think the bottom line is the older generations are just salty because the newer generation is coming in and they have a better way of doing things. And it's not so much that they're changing the way that they're doing things because it's to rebel against what the older generations are doing. It's just that as time goes on, things change, and therefore the methods in which things are done, they also have to change. Now, I'm in this heated discussion where basically I am being admonished, ignored, called names by older people, mind you. I'm being called ignorant. I'm being called misinformed. I'm being called all of these things. Now, mind you, nothing I've said is a lie, you know, and nothing I've said did not happen, okay? So, all of this is in regards to the ADOS movement. And I think really, it's really no issue here other than the older generations are just having a hard time adjusting to the fact that they're no longer the ones carrying the torch, okay? At the root of it, that's what I believe it is, because older people have a problem with not being in control. But anyway, I think one of the largest misconceptions about the ADOS movement is it's trying to separate people from pan-Africanism. When that is not the case. Okay, so a large talking point of ADOS is reparations, all right? ADOS is not just about reparations. ADOS is a political movement, okay? Understand that it is a political movement. If you don't understand that, I'm going to need you to go back and I'm going to need you to study the later years of Malcolm X. Malcolm X was creating a political movement with a black agenda before he was killed. Okay, after he was killed, nobody picked up that end of the torch. That is highly important. Why? Because it is not as if Europe is this unified nation under one government. That is not the case. Each of these European countries are still very independent, and they are very well under their own control and rule. They will have their own ways of doing stuff. They will have their own economies. They will have their own ways of doing things, okay? Now, each one of these nations that participated in the slave trade owes reparations to the group of people that it held in captivity. Okay? Make sense? No? If you don't get it, I'm sorry. But come on now. For instance, Belgium did really bad things to the Congo. Therefore, the Congolese would need to petition Belgium for payment or reparations for what it did to their country. Does that have anything to do with African Americans? No. Not at all. If Brazil decided it needed to pay or provide reparations to the Brazilians who came over through the transatlantic slave trade, does it have anything to do with Jamaicans? No. They would have to take that up with the Brazilians, the Portuguese, I believe. I could be wrong. So many different countries, so many different places. But hopefully y'all get what I'm saying. You would have to get your payment from the places that contributed to your bondage, okay? Therefore, ADOS is trying to get repayment from the American government for the Africans that were brought from Africa to America and made to be slaves. Now, here's one issue. I saw the argument that, oh, I won't support ADOS because it got the word slave in it. Let me remove my eyes. If that ain't the most ignorant ass shit I have ever motherfucking heard, that's some stupid shit to say. First of all, on African soil, your ass was an African. On American soil, your ass was an African that's about to be held in bondage, which would make you a slave. I don't care how you feel about the word. It is what it is. We have ancestors that were held in captivity against their will, and that makes you a slave. Our ancestors were slaves. Point blank, bottom line. They were enslaved, so they were slaves. You ain't got to like the word or whatever, but we talking about dealing with the American government. That is the terminology. That is what was used. That is what it is. And we not finna go and color up some damn words just so y'all can feel better about what happened. That's some ignorant ass shit. Especially when you talking about doing stuff on a political arena. See, because reparations will come from individual nations, then you have to play the game of the nation that you're trying to get payment from. In America, if you do not have government representation, you're not going to get shit done. That's why they have lobbyists. That's why they have all these special interest groups. So I have all this different shit that goes up to Washington and speak on the behalf of whatever their group is to get stuff done. This is why you look at people's platforms and you put certain people into office. Because if you don't have representation, you're not going to get anything done. For the past 100 years, a little more than 100 years, we haven't had any government representation as far as a black agenda. ADOS is looking at people who are running for prominent positions in office to ask them in your platform, do you have an African-American agenda? And if you do not have an African-American agenda, then why would we throw our support behind you? That's a political movement. I don't understand how you decide that participating in the government to get what you need is separating you from your pan-Africanism. Because look at what's happening now. We have white people that are running for office of president talking about reparations for African Americans. That hasn't happened before. So why would you not support ADOS? Why? They not up there talking about some conference that happened in the early damn 90s and this is why they talking about this now. It is 2019. You mean to tell me yo 20 years ago, over 20 years ago, some conference you have is now swaying political parties? Fuck out of here. No, it's not. It is the work of the youth now, in the production of things like ADOS that has brought this to the political arena enough for it to take center stage and become a talking point for people on their platforms to run for the highest office in the land. And you're not going to support it because you don't like the word slave? Fuck out of here! What is wrong with y'all? Then at the same time, these same elders talking all this shit about being unified and pan-Africanism. You can't unify with the youth in your own country, but you means to tell me you can unify with all the countries in Africa and all the countries across the diaspora, but you can't unify with the young people you live with? What? Another thing, there are some people that don't want to have that support ADOS, that don't want to have anything to do with Pan-Africanism. I'm not saying they right. I'm not saying they wrong. All I'm saying is, I understand. And my whole thing is, for all these elders that have such a problem with ADOS, if you really concerned about preserving the stability of Pan-Africanism, the unity of Pan-Africanism, you will listen to these young people, you will validate their feelings, and then you will explain to them why things happen the way they happen. It makes absolutely no sense that you grow up and you were told Africa is home, Africa is the mecca of your blackness, and you grow up and you decide you're going to delve into some history yourself. And inside of history, you find out that Africans were stealing other Africans to give to Europeans so they can get guns to fight other Africans. You don't think that's some disheartening shit for somebody to find out when you've never been given this narrative? So when you find this out and you've never been told this, you like, yo, that's kind of fucked up. Then let's go further. You go find out that the narrative of the European just came into Africa and ravaged it, and you find out that's not true, because you find out that Africans had been trading with Europeans for hundreds of years prior to them starting to steal people and destabilize the countries. So then you start to think, well, if you trading with them, how is it that they end up taking over your shit? And you find out that greed and greed and money, basically the same thing, power, clouded their foresight to see that these people are moving into their territory. You know, this type of stuff make you wonder, you always given this narrative that Africans were victims, but you never given the side where, no, they may have been victims, but some of this is stupid. Because of greed, they dismissed the fact that, oh, he done went from gathering his stuff on the shore to now they building military stations on the coastline. Oh, now they done moved into a certain area of the town. You know, we talking about the age of conquest here. So if you know you battling other Africans, you know, for power, why would you not think that the Europeans would try to get you? And these are questions that don't get answered, okay? Couple that with some of the experiences that some African Americans have with Africans. There are Africans that will come here and tell us that we lazy, that's why we can't get nowhere, because we don't do nothing, we ain't worth shit. Now, fortunately for me, I've not had that experience. All the Africans that I have met have been very nice to me. They try to teach me things about the continent or whatever, so I've not had that experience, but I have heard it, you know, I've heard it in passing. I've heard it in the store where the Africans had these convenience stores in these neighborhoods. I've heard them say stuff like that to the people in the neighborhood. When Africans come over here, it's not like they take what they earn. They take what they earn and they send it home. They're not putting that stuff back into the black community. But we all supposed to be unified, right? You are over here making money here, but you're not doing anything to support the black people that's here. Your money is going home to your country where it's going to benefit your economy. You're taking from our economy that still owe us to give it to your economy to build it up. We don't benefit from that. So for somebody to say they not gonna support ADOS because it's exclusionary. Excuse me? No, that's not even it. It is the fact that we are claiming our American heritage as well as our African heritage. See, African Americans have been taught that they need to shun their American ways and embrace the African. Some of us can't even establish relationships with Africans to know anything about the continent, the culture, the tribes. I was just talking to a lady earlier today, and she was telling me how she was supposed to go to Nigeria for like 20 days, and she can't go because she needs a special kind of passport, to which she already has two different types of passports. So since she already has those two, she can't get the special one that's required for Nigeria. And then, well, the visas are kind of standard. A lot of countries want you to have visas for them to come in to the country. So, and it was some other things that she was telling me about that was kind of ridiculous. Like, it's a painstaking process to even get there. Not even talking about the cost, you know. And so you couple all of that. If you can't quantify and understand why these people feel like, you know, Pan-Africanism is not for me, then you're not paying attention, and neither do you care to be unified. Because if you care to be unified, you would listen and understand to what these people had to say. And then you would try to build a conversation off of it. Me, I'm not polarized against this. I don't care whether you want to be Pan-African or not. All I know is there are some debts to be paid. And we need to get it however we can get it. That's basically how I feel about it. So, I don't really care. But I'm open to listen to the conversation. And it cannot continue to be this narrative. Not if you want unity from the younger generations of African Americans. You can't keep having this conversation where you only look at the African as this weak-ass victim. Because that's not the truth. Yes, they were victimized. But hey, they made some bad, it was some bad decision making there, and it was some, there was some corruptness going on, and that stuff has to be discussed. Is it the bulk of why things happen? No, like, Europeans knew, they had a projected plan from the moment they got there, what they was gonna do to that land. Now, when I say that land, I'm talking about the whole continent. They already knew what they wanted to do with that land. But that doesn't mean that just because they had a plan, you don't have a responsibility to maintain and protect your land. I'm just saying, and to ignore these facts and tell people that they wrong and they misinformed and all this, and to say that you're not going to support a movement that's clearly bringing traction to what a goal that we've been trying to reach for over 100 years. To say you're not going to support, you're fucking ignorant. And it ain't got nothing to do with age at this point. It's fucking pride and it's fucking ignorance. And you don't get to maintain the status of elder running around causing harm because of your pride and your fucking ignorance. Because it's fucking ignorant. And when you can't have a conversation with the youth, you fuck up the relationship between the young and the old. And if the young is in power, who gonna take care of the old when you done fucked up the relationship because you couldn't have an honest conversation? Like, cut it the fuck out. Validate these people's feelings because these things did happen. Validate these people's feelings because their experiences have happened and they do matter. Validate these people's feelings because there is a painstaking process in order to do these things. Validate their feelings. Because the truth of the matter is, America owes African Americans. It does. And the French owe a whole bunch of people. And yes, collectively, we can get that by helping each other, giving each other the political strategies that we are all using to make these people pay each group what they owe. That's how we unify. Not sitting up here talking about, oh, you can't just ask for reparations for your country. What the hell? You sound dumb. Who gonna pay us? Europe? Ain't no damn Europe treasury. What the heck? Yo, y'all tripping hard. It's a new day. And basically, I feel like ADOS is picking up where Malcolm X left off, and I have no problems with it. And if you do, something's wrong with you. And you ain't about unity. And that's just the end of that.